Welcome to another video on solving trig equations. The goal of this video is to solve trig equations using a variety of strategies. If you look at this first equation, it may be difficult to know how to approach it. We may try to add these two fractions together by obtaining a common denominator. But what I think might be helpful is multiplying this second fraction by the conjugate of the denominator. Let's see what this does. So this first fraction will stay the same. In the denominator, we're going to have 1 minus sine squared theta. And we'll leave the numerator in factored form. Now, 1 minus sine squared theta is equal to cosine squared theta. So let's go ahead and do that substitution now. And now this second fraction simplifies. There's a common factor of cosine theta. So this simplifies out. This will be to the first power. And now notice that we have two fractions with a common denominator. So we can go ahead and add these two fractions together. Our denominator will be cosine theta. And the numerator will have 1 plus 1. That would be 2. And notice our sine theta is also simplified out. We have sine theta plus a negative sine theta. That would be 0. So we have 2 over cosine theta equals 4. Now to solve this equation for cosine theta, we may want to perform cross product. So 4 cosine theta equals 2 dividing by 4. All this comes down to, where is cosine theta equal to 1/2? Having a cosine function value of 1/2 should remind you of a 30-60-90 right triangle, where the cosine of a 60 degree angle is equal to 1/2. That tells us our reference triangle. That tells us our reference angle will be 60 degrees. Next, we want to note, next, cosine theta is positive in both the first and the fourth quadrant, since cosine theta involves x. So let's go ahead and sketch a 60 degree reference angle in the first and the fourth quadrants. These two angles will have a cosine function value of 1/2. Therefore, theta could be 60 degrees, or pi over 3 radians. Or theta could also be 300 degrees, or 5 pi over 3 radians. So this equation was fairly involved. But remember, one of those strategies we were using to verify identities was to multiply by the conjugate. Let's take a look at another. Here we have secant squared x minus 2 tan x equals 4. Well, we can replace secant squared x with tan squared x plus 1. Let's go ahead and do that. We have an equation that looks like it's going to be in quadratic form. So let's go ahead and set it equal to 0 and rearrange the order of these terms. If we subtract 4 on both sides, we'll have minus 3 on the left. And luckily this is factorable. Tan squared x is a perfect square. Now we can place the factors of negative 3 in the second positions. Put a minus 3 here and a plus 1 here. Our outer product is negative 3 tan x. Inner product is positive 1 tan x, which does sum to the middle term. So if this product is equal to 0, then either tan x must equal negative 1 or tan x must equal 3. Having a tangent function value of negative 1 should remind us of the 45-45-90 right triangle, where the tangent of 45 degrees is equal to positive 1. So since we want a function value of negative 1, we have to determine which quadrants the tangent function would be negative. It would be negative in the second quadrant, so we'll sketch a 45 degree reference angle here. And it would also be negative in the fourth quadrant. Remember, tangent is y over x. So here, x could equal 90 plus 45, or 135 degrees, or 3 pi over 4 radians, or 315 degrees, which would be 7 pi over 4. Okay, for tan x equals 3, we're going to have to use our calculators because this does not come out to a nice reference angle. Remember, if we solve this equation for x by taking the inverse tangent of both sides, we would have x equals inverse tangent 3. So let's go to the calculator now. Make sure we're in radian mode. We are. So second tangent brings up the inverse. Looks like we have approximately 1.25 radians. Going back to our coordinate plane, 1.25 radians would be in the first quadrant. Well, tangent is also positive in the third quadrant. So if we sketch a reference angle of 1.25 radians, we can determine another angle in this interval that has a tangent function value of 3. So that would be pi plus 1.25 radians, which is approximately 3.93. So it looks like we have four different solutions for this equation. I think we have time for one more. Okay, on this last problem, we have two different trig functions, both with double angles. So what we'll try to do is use these double angle identities and perform some substitutions to make this easier to solve. Luckily, there's only one identity for sine 2x. So let's go ahead and replace sine 2x with 2 sine x cosine x. Now for cosine 2x, there's three different identities to choose from. The one that stands out for me is this third one, because notice we have cosine 2x equals 2 cosine squared x minus 1. Notice there's a plus 1 in the original equation, so those two will simplify out if I use this identity. So let's go ahead and give it a try. Cosine 2x is equal to 2 cosine squared x minus 1, and then plus 1 from the original equation. So these will go out. And now let's go ahead and try to set this equation equal to 0. Now this is factorable. There's a common factor of 2 cosine x. Let's try factoring that out. That's going to leave us with sine x minus cosine x equals 0. Now normally, this is going to be a problem having two different trig functions. But let's go ahead and see what we can do with it. So we'll set each of these factors equal to 0. Dividing by 2, we have cosine x equals 0. Now over here, what I'm going to do is move the cosine x to the other side. And now I'm going to divide both sides by cosine x. Remember, sine x over cosine x is tan x. And of course, cosine x divided by cosine x is 1. So we need to find the angles on this interval where cosine x equals 0 and tan x equals 1. Remember, on the unit circle, cosine theta equals x. So we want the points on the unit circle where the x coordinate would be 0. Those occur on the y-axis. So on this interval, we would have pi over 2 radians and also 3 pi over 2. Next, having tan x equal to 1 should remind us of a 45, 45, 90 right triangle, because tangent 45 degrees is equal to 1. So what that tells us is our reference angle is 45 degrees. Remember, tangent is positive in the first quadrant and also in the third quadrant. So we'll sketch a 45 degree reference angle here as well. So the first angle would be pi over 4 radians. And the second angle would be 225 degrees, or 5 pi over 4 radians. So we had a couple non-routine equations here. Hopefully the explanations made sense and you found them somewhat helpful. I hope you have a good day.